Select Board meeting of July 9th. First on the agenda is the approval of last week's minutes. I made, I think, one typo change and then clarified that the report or the New Hampshire Bond Bank was interested in making sure that our tax exempt status on these projects was the same. So I just clarified that.
Right, no, I saw that.
Yeah.
What you didn't address is, I wanted to insert the letter, the management response letter to the auditor.
It should be on, you can, it's on the website. What do you need, the link or the? Okay, I will send you the link, sorry.
Did you get my changes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So you had some as well?
Well, the date was the 31st of July for the public hearing.
Not the 21st.
And not the 21st. And then I had, there was a spelling error.
Yeah.
Will.
Right.
I think was the word.
Yeah, I needed a word.
Yeah.
The public hearing is 21st?
31st.
31st.
The Tuesday, the 31st.
For the space needs.
For the police station.
Oh, right, right, not, oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, sorry.
Got it.
So I just needed to make sure.
Perfect.
Well, no, actually.
Yeah, not it, it was fine.
Okay, so by consensus, we're good with the minutes?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a good question.
All right, community input. I see Rain.
Oh, well, I'm actually here just to find out what your transition plan is going to be because I heard the devastating news that you are moving. And so I wanted to be here for that.
It's probably not till later on.
That's okay.
In the meeting.
I'm here. And also, I'm hoping I can catch up with the fire chief and maybe temporarily after he does his thing, I can run up and ask him.
All right, good enough. Anything else? Yes.
I was at the transfer station today. Does anyone know when the window's going to be fixed in the new shed?
George?
We get a chance to get to it.
There we go. There's the answer. Thank you. Appreciate it. Anything else? Okay. Department head, well, very conveniently, George, you've walked in right on time.
I have nothing unless you have stuff for me.
No, I can just tell you that, I'll tell you and the board that I think I'd be copying you, I don't know about the board, on my emails to the Stratford Regional Planning Commission so we can get the road surface management system sort of on track. And so board, what Colin Lentz, who's probably going to be the staff person primarily in charge, is we're going to be talking about options, like what would it cost us if we did a full reassessment of the roads? Which if you ask me right this very moment, I would say we don't need. That really, we can just update it with the work that we've done and kind of go on from there. And maybe talk about, I don't know, what a complete revale of the roads would cost. Maybe something we want to do every 3 years, every 5 years, I don't know, but I don't think we need to do it this year. But we are going to meet, there's no date yet, but George and I will meet with Colin just to review options. I'll bring them back to the board and we can see how we want to manage it. So there was that. The only other thing that I was going to talk about is based on the conversation I had with Caroline this morning, you and she are meeting with NRRA, Northeast.
Resources.
Northeast Recovery Resource Association, or something like that.
Yeah.
We pay dues, they're our primary recycling assistant, and they're going to be providing some data on how we might manage the change from single stream recycling. One of the things that is to, it's not to our benefit, this is a, you know, it's one of the things that we have to address. One of the things that may help in the PR we do to the town is that there's more and more information out there, just generally available to the public, on what is not just our crisis in recycling, but in the nation's crisis in recycling due to China. China's just stomping down on the quality of what it is willing to accept. So we'll just wait to hear what some of the ideas.
You said something, you had questions on the road price.
Oh, I do. So, yes, so I just wanted to, you know, she's going to give me the quarter-two figures soon. And one of the things that I'm going to try to do is see how much money I can scrape together for various potential personnel-related issues, some of which are you know, related to my transition out, some maybe not, maybe things we wanted to try to do anyway. So I saw that the Pike final, I guess it's the final contract, is less than $290. So my question was, when I left, there was all this hoo-ha, we had to get it up to over $300 because of the gravel. So what happened? I'm delighted.
We haven't bought the shoulder gravel yet.
Okay.
But that's gonna be minimal.
Could you help me with minimal? I mean, that's gonna be.
He said it's only about 100 tons, so that's not gonna, it's gonna be less than $3,000.
Okay, alright.
And I got some already, and we did stockpile, so, you know, so that's gonna help, we're gonna, you know, we just, I wanna keep some on hand.
Sure, sure.
We need it. But, that's, we did a lot of work with them, so, you know, we helped them out with different things, and that helped keep the cost down.
Cost down, that's great.
So, and, you know.
So I did draft an update to the town. I think I sent a copy to you and the board and Caroline, is that familiar? I sent it, did it last week? No? Did it end up in my draft and I didn't send it?
I don't remember seeing it.
I don't remember seeing it.
Uh-oh.
On what?
Just the road update.
Oh, I did remember seeing it, yes.
And I wanted a paragraph at the end that said, here are the projects that.
Okay, I, that was way, I didn't do anything on it yet.
What we had done, yeah, this is what, right.
Yeah, I did see it.
Okay.
Can I ask? Sorry.
No, please.
No, it's not about this, go ahead.
Oh, alright. So, it would be helpful if you could sit with Caroline this week.
Yeah, I can get that done.
Just review it. I mean, what I wanna make sure is the language that I've used is appropriate, correct? And then the thing at the end is what we're hoping to do with the remainder of the money for this year. And with some, I don't know how I started it, but, you know, we may not be able to do all of them, but with these things that we are considering for the remainder of the money. The fire engine, locust, the whole locust.
Yeah, part of the locust tree, a couple sites.
The whole list that you brought to us last week. So that would be helpful if you could sit with Caroline and do that.
Okay, that kind of answered my question, I think. But because I thought I was going to ask the question is, why can't we use the road maintenance money for all the projects that you had indicated last week? Because I thought you were taking them from departments, individual departments. Like Mark was.
We were going to use some of that. We're trying to keep the cost down. When I asked him to use his money.
Okay.
When this all started, not knowing what the final bill is. This is prior. This was made prior to the final bill.
Oh, okay.
So we can look at that. You know, that definitely we can use that.
Well, because we're limited to what we can use that money for, right? It was on a warrant. So it has to be used on roads, right?
No, it's not a. No, it's part of our operating budget.
It wasn't a warrant article.
It wasn't a warrant. Remember, that's all
it changed back
cost
into
us.
The budget.
Yeah, it cost
they
us.
They wanted to put the road money in.
Oh, that's right, it failed.
Yes.
That's right, okay. But
yeah,
even so, though, if we
right.
have money in that,
no,
why?
No,
we
definitely.
Shouldn't hit individual departments, kind of shorting them out to get
no,
these projects done.
No, that, like I said, this list was made
okay.
by you.
Okay,
and we can may look at a different way of doing it, you know. I mean, we can probably do the prepping for it and have a paving contract paving the bigger sections instead of trying to do it piecemeal. Which would be better. I mean, we can do the job. It's not a case that we can't do the job. But I mean, if we have the money available to.
Yeah, I think at first, you know, we thought this contract was going to be, it was when I left, it was upping 305, 306.
Yeah.
It was,
yeah,
you know, with each new discovery, it
came a lot better than we expected. They probably didn't use quite as much gravel as they had to, or, you know, in that rate. Too,
as
so.
Anticipated.
But, I was a little surprised it was a little lower than what they anticipated.
So, and there's nothing.
He said
that's it.
Final bill. Okay. The thing they're going to fix on the corner of Bay Road where they broke with the trucks, that's not going to be a cost to us. Boundary Street's not going to be a cost to us.
Okay.
Excellent. So.
All right. I don't think there was anything else. I know that Caroline drafted a message about the recyclable. I didn't have a chance to look at it. Did you? Michael was
there.
Just this afternoon.
About the email that said that we had some wrong. Deliveries.
We didn't do it.
Well, I know.
Nothing we're aware of.
Oh, no. That's a different issue. No, Caroline is drafting something for the news blog to
right.
alert people that they're going to be, there could be some precipitous changes to how we recycle.
Oh, I didn't see that.
So.
Yeah,
Okay, and maybe lane changes and things like that.
Yeah.
There's gonna have to be some changes.
Yeah, so it's just to alert them, and I think, I hope, I haven't read it, but if, maybe we can take some time later on tonight to, do you have any way to read it? All right, we can, I can bring it up. I didn't read it myself. Michael, did you have one?
I read it earlier today.
And has it seen?
It's been some issues the last week or so.
So what was the miscommunication on that?
Apparently, the waste demo, when Shipyard started trucking, decided to take it to ARC instead of to Waste Management, where we should, where we.
Decided to take it to what? To where?
ARC, it's a recycling center in, I don't know.
It's one in Southport?
They may be affiliated with Manelia. Their trucks are parked at the same place.
Okay.
So, I don't know what the case was there, but they decided to haul stuff that way, and I don't know if they were doing it for other haulers. It sounds like that in the last email I looked from Valerie.
Yeah, she didn't know.
But this should have been handled by Lamprey.
Yeah, so she kind of admitted that there was some miscommunication relayed, but I was a little afraid of.
That miscommunication's costing us some money.
Well, but we shouldn't be held accountable if it wasn't our people who miscommunicated, it was them who miscommunicated. Even though it broke the contract rules with Turnkey.
Waste, yeah, Waste Management.
But how can we be held accountable if they gave them the wrong direction?
Well, I don't think we are. So we're just not paying those bills, and Caroline is trying to sort it out with Valerie.
But it could be contractual problems on our part.
Yeah, it's not on our part. I would say it's not on our part. None of this is on our part.
Okay.
We're noticing it because of the bills, but we're not going to pay them, and we're.
And I wouldn't even have brought that up. Russ called me Sandy because Triano was that wanted to haul away the demo, and he said, is it going to ARC? Is it going to Waste? I said, we don't have a contract with Waste.
Right.
So it goes to Waste.
Goes to Waste.
We'll find out what's going on Monday. That's what's happening. I don't.
Yeah, our demo and our solid waste goes to Turnkey. That's part of the cooperative contract that we've signed. And so, you know, in this time when the truck cooperative disbanded, it, you know, there was a mix-up, but I don't believe any of it is our issue.
Well, that's what I read. It really wasn't us, it was them that was relaying that information.
So, I mean, I don't know how many trucks they made over there, but that's when we started getting bigger charges for our hauling and stuff, so.
Yeah, so we will have, so we're just not paying them at the moment until we figure all of that out. All right, so here's the letter. The Rollinsford Select Board would like to, the draft. The Rollinsford Select Board would like to alert the residents to changes at the transfer station. If you've been paying attention to the news, you may have heard that recycling has very little value. China, once the largest consumer of American recyclable materials, is no longer buying nearly the quantity it once did. Warehouses are storing vast amounts of recycling in hopes the market may turn around. What does this mean for Rollinsford? It no longer makes sense to bundle all of our recycling together. Single-stream recycling, as it is called, no longer makes sense. Each item, whether it be paper, aluminum cans, glass, or a numbered plastic, has a different value. Separating out these items will help us save money. It will likely still cost money to dispose of where we once earned money on it, but it will remain less expensive than throwing it away. Please be aware of new traffic patterns at the transfer station as we work through the numbers to determine how best to make the most of this difficult situation. We hope to find the best way to strike a balance between cost and environmental friendliness. Please be patient for changes going forward. That seem okay?
Yeah.
George?
Yeah.
Okay.
What I would like to do is put a open and close sign at the beginning of Jesse Doe Road so people don't have to waste their time going all the way down there on the day of the transfer, or the hours at Jesse Doe.
So, whereabouts?
Right at the entrance to Jesse Doe, right off to the side that goes up.
By the tracks?
On our shoulder, just over the tracks.
Just over the tracks.
And there was another concern about the tracks. Ed picked up on it coming the other day. Well, if you have to stop the cars coming down Church Street to go to Jesse Doe, where are you parked? On the tracks.
Say that again.
You should be parked on the tracks. Where? Say it again, please. So
you're going, Church Street begins at Main.
Yeah.
And you make the turn to continue to Church Street.
Yeah.
Well, when cars are coming down Church Street, who has the right of way, where does the car start when you're driving in from Main Street? The next stop is the railroad tracks. You're on the tracks. When you're waiting
for the train. I don't remember stopping on the tracks.
You have to stop for the traffic.
What George is saying, if a car is coming the other direction from on Church Street towards the transfer station going down.
And you didn't see it soon enough?
And you have to stop, if you have to stop to see that, to stop for that car, your line will be sitting on the railroad tracks, which could pose an issue. And the thought was, is could we put the stop sign at Church and Jesse Doe and make Jesse Doe the right of way?
Highway Safety Committee? So that's a good question to ask of Chief Duchar. And he'll call his committee, and you may even be on it.
I am on it.
Yes, so those kinds of things are.
But I just wanted to bring it up, you know, I mean, it is a safety issue, because.
Good point, you didn't think about it.
You know, if you don't think about it and you're sitting on that track, don't take much for that.
No, I just, yeah, exactly, it comes flying down, absolutely.
And you're on the tracks and you think of no place to go, you're in the gates.
Yeah.
But Ed is safety minded, and that was one thing he brought up.
Well, that's a good idea.
It happened to him because he had gone beyond to see the car coming.
So can we, all right, so that, please take that to the Highway Safety Committee. To wind back though, your other question was about the hours.
Hours for transfer station, I mean, we have people coming in and turning around in the front of the yard, and I mean, it's a pain in the butt for everybody.
Yeah.
If we're trying to back a truck out and stuff like that.
Well, again, bring it to the Highway Safety Commission.
And see if, I mean.
And see if that's the right place.
I think that's a great idea.
Yeah, I mean,
It would save a lot of people from driving all the way down into the transfer station with their trash and, you know, I mean, we could probably get the signs from NR, because we have points.
Yes, because we get once a year, we can get free something.
You know, and have a nice looking sign that says, you know, nothing.
But you would have to have two, one for spring, one for summer.
No, you just have a flip. Have your, some, all your hours on it.
Oh, okay.
But then when they're open, just flip the sign down, open or close.
So somebody would have to do that.
Oh, I see, versus telling them the hours.
Every day.
Yeah.
Except, you know, when they go into work, they can put the sign open today.
Yeah, that's true.
You know?
I would say, you know, for placement and for any other potential traffic related issues, bring it up with the Highway Safety Committee.
No, I mean, that was, you know, a couple of things.
I think it's a great idea.
But what I hear most about is, what days are you open and what hours are you open? So that's, you know, I wish we could have something posted with that info as well.
There is a sign at, on the gate, and there's a sign right next to it.
We're already down there.
But you're already there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And a lot of people say, well, Google says you're open every day. Well, we're not open every day.
Well, I know that. But once it's on Google, you can't get it off, right? I mean, that was old.
Someone was saying they were going to try to work to get it off.
Kristen, I know, Kristen Palenko, but I'm not sure.
And every time they call to update our Google info, I tell them I'm only the road agent, and they hang up on me. They won't give me, you know. I said, this is the town entity. Google calls me 15 times a week to update our Google information. But as soon as I tell them I'm not, you know, it's a town entity, they hang up on me. Or if I tell them I'm the road agent, then you can't make a decision, you know. I said, I can tell you what's going on, but that's, I mean, that's the kind of response I get from Google. And I, you know, and I get these calls 3-4 times a day sometimes. Just like, you want to buy a house, or you want to do this? But, you know, I get
Google
calls me 3 or 4 times a day, sometimes by 5 days a week.
Related to your work for the town, or just?
It just comes across on my phone, so whether it's, and then I get the Google call at the town sometime, at the garage number. Wanting to update our info. Every time I try to talk to them, they hang up on me. So.
Block them.
I don't
That doesn't work anymore. They find more ways of getting into your phone today. I mean, I got a caller ID, sent it with someone to fire chief, and it was nowhere near him. It was somewhere from out of state. You know, and it says phone number, and I knew who it was.
Yeah.
But, you know.
I think otherwise we're good.
Okay. We're going to start the shouldering probably towards the end of the week on Heritage, and we start doing the stuff. And we did pass some holes along Flagle today that were getting pretty rough. So.
At what point do you need to rent
the roller? We may do the shoulders without the roller. We might use the backhoe to roll with the backhoe. That's heavier than actually a small roller would be, and that would work all right.
All right.
When we start doing the hot top projects, we'll look at it. I might talk to them and see if they have one we could borrow, something like that. Just, you know, whatever way we can do something. See what our options are. We got time to work on it.
George, what's wrong with the window in the new building at the highway department, or the transfer station?
That happened in the winter.
in there.
And we gotta take, what we gotta do is take the wall apart the way it was installed. So it's not just a.
It's a big job.
It's not just, you know, a few minute thing.
I hadn't noticed it out down.
It wasn't installed, you know, they put the plywood on after the window was in place, so it's, you know, it's fine, it's built fine, it's the way it was done, it's basically allowed to take part. So.
Okay.
Other than that, I think, I'll keep you updated on things that come up, and.
All right, thank you, George.
All right, John.
Have a nice evening. And see any other department heads, so we'll go with town administration. Budgets of the resident tax and the inventories, I've asked our tax collector to please come and talk to us about this in time this month. She was gonna try, she at first said she could come tonight, and then I saw an email not too long ago that said that she interrupted to, she'd forgotten about another appointment she had, so she won't be here tonight, but she will be coming to talk to us about both of those issues. So the, I should be getting from Caroline, who's on vacation next week, but I should be getting by the end of this week, there are two numbers, and one of the things that I have to do is see where I can scrape money, so that we can use them for various aspects of transition plan, or, you know, other kinds of personnel related things that we might be wanting to do to help the situation. So maybe I'll have some preliminary data next Monday, but certainly at least by the fall, Monday after that, we should have some information. And the other thing, and this is more related to the transition, but, you know, I haven't actually written the, my official letter of resignation, it was gonna be as of, like, the last meeting in July. I could up it till the end of that week, which would allow me then to go to that budget meeting and provide the quarter two report. But if you would prefer to not have me do it, I mean, I'm cool, either way. However you wanna work it.
I'm fine with you being there, but we need to appoint people who are going to be there, so it means, I'm willing to do it, I don't know what Michael's feeling says.
It could be effective by the end of Friday.
So then I will plan on doing that one, thank you. All right, zoning ordinance. So, you know, one of the things that, as I, you know, continue to think about how to make our meetings more efficient, is changing who is, or having our building inspector sign, have his signature on our building permits and certificates of occupancy be all that is necessary. In other words, you're really select board for that. So the zoning ordinance, however, as Michael pointed out early on, specifically says the select board. And I've gone back and forth a couple of times with the municipal association, and you could try and say that it applies or designee, but it doesn't explicitly state that, so the safest thing is, of course, to have the board do it. And then I said, okay, well, can we do it, you know, outside of a meeting? In other words, have at least two of us sign it outside of a meeting. And that came back, no. The only thing that you can do that for is manifests. So we have to do it, but I would like to see what the board thinks about asking Caroline to go through the zoning ordinance, or one of us, it doesn't make any difference, and propose the changes necessary to make the building inspector be the person who does this, and submit that change to the planning board as a proposed zoning ordinance change, which would come before the town in March.
My only concern with that would be if for some reason we change our building inspector. I mean, I have a lot of faith in Tom Clark because he's dealt with Rollins for years and years and years. But what happens when he has to retire? Then I don't know.
Well, do you anticipate that we wouldn't hire a building inspector?
No, but I just don't know if it would be someone who is familiar enough with Rollinsford, and I don't know, I'm just throwing out a concern. That's, I mean, yeah.
Let me suggest this. I mean, having been on a board that actually looked at these things, we were not qualified to look at these things.
Oh, agreed.
And to make to see whether the amounts were correct or applicable. So, you know, the assumption is that the building inspector, we would hopefully hire somebody who is qualified, who understands building trades and who can do this sort of thing. Now, how about though, I mean, we could, you know, we're making a change. We could say the select board or the building inspector, you know, we could write it so that it gives us an optimum leeway.
We misunderstood you.
Yes.
So what he's doing today is all of the legwork and everything for us. So when I sign that, I already know that he has reviewed this completely.
Yes.
And I'm just signing as an authorization to go forward.
As I am.
So that's not what we're talking about. He's still going to do that, but then he's going to be the only signature now.
Correct.
Okay.
Which is what happens in other towns. So it would not come here. We wouldn't lose any public information because the log is going to be online. And so, you know, so anybody wants to see the building permits that have been approved or they're in the pipeline or whatever would be available on the website or, you know, through town hall. You just come and take a look at them. In the meantime, in the short term, so there are two issues. So one is, and you know, we certainly don't need to make that decision tonight, but it would be helpful for the board to actively consider, like, you know, your concerns about just having the building inspector, which is, you know, what a lot of municipalities do. And that way, you know, the business continuity is enhanced, because now it doesn't have to wait till the Monday. And as you know, in particular, the certificates of occupancy are problematic. I've signed some outside of meetings and had to bring them back. I think you had
I
to sign
them.
Exactly. Because there are residents who are ready to close. They don't know that they're closing. All of a sudden, everything comes together. And their bank closing is ready, and they need the certificate of occupancy, or they can't close.
Right.
So, you know, from a business continuity point of view, you know, our Monday meetings can be roadblocks for some things that in other municipalities just kind of move forward. I think, you know, building permits is one of these things. And so I would encourage the board, if you don't want to, you know, ask Caroline to sort of go through the zoning ordinance and kind of come back with a proposed change, that's fine. But I think, you know, I encourage you to us to actively, you know, consider doing so. We can revisit it again next week. Do you have any thoughts, Mike?
I don't really know what I think about it. I think certificate of occupancy, it makes sense to have that signed off by the building inspector. He's actually going over to do the inspection to see if it is ready to be signed off on. I mean, we don't actually go over and look at anything. So.
No, but he actually does sign it.
Right.
He signs it.
He signs the building permits.
Yeah.
We're just,
right. But,
you know, to be honest, I feel we're rubber stamping it.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
But also a roadblock, because until we rubber stamp it,
right,
things can't go forward.
Yeah. So I don't need much convincing on the CEOs, but I'm not sure what building permits. I gotta think about tomorrow. I can think of two for sure, maybe three, times past select boards that I sat on. The chair who filled them out for us and reviewed them for us when I first got on. Sent applications, building forms off that were commercial, and should have gone through the planning process for site review for certain properties and certain ones it was caught, but then it was caught and people had to go back and go through site review. I think we've solved that problem by having Mr. Clark do it. So I guess that could be evidence for. To back up what you're saying, but I'm not there yet, so I gotta think about it some more. I'm trying to figure out what reason, other than the fact that they didn't have anyone to do the administrative work, it was just everything dumped on the select board to do. If that's just the case, why it says the select board has to do it, or if there's another reason why. So then I'd like to look at what other towns do too.
So when someone gets a building permit and it gets approved through the process, Who do they come to see and pay and gets notified? How does that happen?
I think in a very number of ways. I mean, I think often Caroline or the front office, once it's been signed, there's the exchange, sometimes the check is with it, and so someone will call and say your building permit is ready. You know, actually, Salme may have more direct information.
They have, they put the building permits that have been approved on the counter in the front office. And then you come in to pick it up and pay at that point in time.
Okay, so someone in the front office notifies them that it's ready? Or you just by chance come in and see if it's ready?
Yeah, I don't think they notify right off the bat.
Okay.
I think you have an idea that it's going to the board, will be meeting on Monday, so.
Oh, okay, so they're assuming it's gonna be ready through the board, okay. All right, so that initiation of getting payment and stuff is really taken care of through the front office, once that, all of that stuff?
When people don't pick them up, they call.
Okay.
If they send the folder, they follow up on them.
Oh, yeah.
So after a few months.
Does the person who has a building permit get something to put on their building?
The building permit itself, they get that.
They get the permit itself.
They get that permit and are supposed to post it in a visible manner.
Because how do I get that? I mean, I can get mine.
They should have given you a copy.
You should have your copy.
Well, that's because she left her check here.
Oh, I did, I paid it then.
You know, she didn't give the check.
So you should have a copy.
And you people should have said, she needs to have a copy.
We people should have said, so Denise, we people are gonna say.
Okay, I'll call and ask for a copy. Okay, okay.
I think you get the original, actually.
Oh, okay.
I think you do.
No?
No.
No, we need the original?
Copy.
Oh, all right.
You get a copy, and you're supposed to put it in your window, or somewhere, so it's visible.
Somewhere where it's visible.
I'll come get it, because they're still in construction.
I mean, I've done that, put it in my garage window, and you know, the only person who might see it is the UPS delivery person, you know. Whatever, that's still.
I think it makes a lot of sense in one aspect, I'm always a little concerned when new people that you're not comfortable with might come in and do the job. But then, if we use the word "or" the Board of Selectmen,
yes.
And then we can take time to review before if we had somebody new.
Absolutely, you can do that way.
I think she should at least do the reading and the research.
All right.
Just kind of.
All right.
So,
while we don't have full consensus on this, we'll at least ask Caroline to go through and find those spots and make those, come back to us with what that looks like. So the other thing that, you know, has popped into my head from time to time, and I may have mentioned it, may not have mentioned it, I think that Caroline had found a growth ordinance and sent it along to the planning board last year or something, but nothing ever really came of it. As I was driving, you know, down, it used to be Waterweight there, you know, Dover by the past tunnels.
Yeah.
You know, and all the development that's going on.
Oh, on Dover Point Road?
Yes, Dover Point Road, thank you. I mean, they're like, looks like they're gonna be a gazillion units.
Yes, that's unbelievable.
And so, you know, we have the land available here for similar things to happen to us. And so it's, again, you know, something that I would encourage the board to think about. We don't have to act on anything tonight, but does the action or desire come from us? Are we the ones who might say, would we ask Tom, could you please craft a growth ordinance for us or find one? Or
come from the planning board.
Why should it come from the planning board?
Well, it's going to go through the planning board.
It goes through them.
You can, anyone can bring a proposal to the planning board, but it has to be sponsored by the planning board. The planning board's the ones who are going to hold a public hearing and all that.
Precisely, exactly. But we could encourage them, right?
You could, but the planning board could just say, encourage all you want, just throw it away. So I don't want you to waste your time. I don't want anyone to waste their time.
Has anyone on the planning board mentioned
it? Until you come to the planning board and then discuss it with them first and make sure that there's interest. At least the majority of the planning board's interested in doing it. That's not anything.
Has the planning board discussed it at all?
We had a preliminary conversation, very preliminary, when she first sent it, I'm trying to think what town it is.
North Town, Allison, I don't know, somewhere, it was somewhere.
Somewhere over by Concord, that was dealing with similar, it was restricting growth to X amount of houses, or X amount of building permits for new construction per year, I don't know, something like that.
Or a percentage, or, yeah, it was some.
Yeah, it was something like that. At the time, there didn't seem to be a lot of interest, but that doesn't mean that this planning board isn't gonna be interested. I mean, we might have also just run out of time, so. Before the,
So.
Before the March meeting, but.
So, and Caroline's an alternate, right?
She is now, yeah.
Right, maybe.
So, can we go back just for a moment?
Yes.
Just something to think about issuing the building permits. We have one ongoing and one potential application to build on a Class 6 road. Where the sole discretion to allow building, issue a building permit lies with the select board by statute. That's something you just wanna keep in mind. If you are, if you really wanna move forward with changing how the building permits are issued, that's something you wanna keep in mind. If a subsection needs to be crafted or something, that deals with that, because what's it to Tom Clark? Or, I don't pick on Tom, to the building inspector, code enforcement officer, whoever it is that ultimately has a job, could be Mr. or Mrs. X in the future, you know, what are they? They don't have the same level of obligation and I'll say commitment to the community, because they don't reside here. They're not an elected official in this community versus just an employee that may or may not reside in the town. There is a difference in my mind, as someone who's responsible to the voters, to the residents, but.
Well, I'd like to think that an employee is responsible to the select board to do his or her job adequately, and.
Right.
So, I mean, clearly if a Class 6 road permit has to come before the board, I mean, one of the things we asked Tom to do is make sure that all of the correct zoning ordinances are followed. So if it's supposed to come to us, then he would make sure that it did come.
I mean, that could be one of the things to say, I mean.
So, but I made a note, so we can.
But we need to be careful, there aren't other instances like that, that we're just not thinking about, so a thorough review of the zoning ordinance, I think would be in order.
With regard to those spots that say yes, yes, that's what I thought I would ask Caroline to serve. Okay, in the meantime, in the short term, one of the things that we could do is just, you know, when the thing is, when the building permits are online, is we could just sit here quietly and just sign them. And it would take maybe a half the time that it does to read them into the public, because all, what we would do is then have some stock phrase that just says, the select board, you know, signed, reviewed and signed building permits.
Yeah, that's right.
For an online, you know, to see them, either come to town hall or look online, and it could just be one stock sentence. It would save you time, would save time to review them.
It'd just be simply a list, you know, permit number and whatever, 2018-001, and the address, and electrical, or new construction, whatever, yeah.
We have that, that's our law.
Yeah, no, I understand that, I get that, what I'm saying, I'm backing up what you're saying. It could just be put in the minutes and online. It could just be a running tally of building permits. Doesn't have, you don't have to sit and it's archaic to sit here and meet or read or whoever it comes after me, read the number and the type code.
Yeah, I
would hope that people have a better thing to do with their time or anything.
And it's not a good way to, if you wanted to look at building permits, it's good to have them all in one spot, not just a couple of, in this meeting, meeting to a couple here, a couple there. So we can try that tonight, if there's some in there. In the meantime, I see another department head. Chief?
My turn?
It is your turn.
Quick service.
It is.
I'm great with you.
We can't always accommodate in that way, but.
I appreciate it. Bills to pay, and then kind of waited a little bit to give you a couple of numbers I want.
Yeah, I see you brought some.
A little information for those two guys that I wanted to be aware of. First business is PO number 1433. It's to the New Hampshire State Firemen Association for our annual dues for the members that still involved, and that's gonna come out of the association due line, it's $580.
PO 1433, New Hampshire State Fireman's Association, $580, so moved.
Second.
Any discussions? It's in your budget line, all right, all those in favor say aye.
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 Second one I have is on 1432, Seacoast Chief Fire Officers Mutual Aid District, and it's for our annual assessment for breathing apparatus support.
Testing.
This isn't so much for the testing, this is to help maintain the three trailers that the Seacoast Chiefs have available, so if they go to an incident, they get called to a fire, those things are maintained and ready to go. And what happens is every community that's involved in the Seacoast Chief Officers, which is like everybody, they assess you a certain amount per pack, and we have 17 packs, so whatever that works.
So it's our share of.
It's our share of the whole thing, whereas over 60 packs, so they're paying thousands of dollars, so it's just a matter of how many units you have,
right,
and what's available for you, or if you call up that trailer. And that's $340 for the annual assessment.
I'll move purchase order number 1432, Seacoast Chief Fire Officers Mutual Aid, for $340 for breathing apparatus support.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
We can all let go with Caroline and some other stuff. And all the paperwork for the fire inspector, firemen's association is there. That's all I have to do.
Oh, these are the invoices, okay.
Question?
Can you put a fireworks permit out in the office for me so I can pick it up on my way home, please?
For the.
My day?
Yeah.
September 22nd.
I'll get a date to bring it home here.
I'll never get it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Sometimes it's, yep, sometimes it's best to use the formal channel, yes.
I'll observe the request and off we go.
Thank you.
So George was here earlier.
Yeah.
And he was talking about, you know, paving the front or rebuilding the front, those couple ramps that are. Yes, and so he may have had a conversation with you about maybe seeing if some of your maintenance money could come out. We're not sure. That we may be able to cover it all, so it's a work in progress, it depends on what else comes about.
Yeah,
so.
Actually we just stopped at the station,
okay.
And we had that discussion.
Oh, all right.
Well, he's also looking for an engine to go down the culvert on Sligo Road.
Oh, yeah, to see about blowing it out.
So one of our members is going to go down tomorrow.
Oh, good.
And try to put some high pressure water through it and see.
Okay. Excellent.
Help out in any way we can.
Good, that's super.
Yeah. And the other reason why I'm here is the two members that are sitting behind me,
yes.
Members of the fire department, obviously.
Yes.
They're kind of, some of the money that we invest in people, when I tell you that we send them to school and whatnot, those are two members that have completed their certifications. They went through their level one and level two certifications, a class that they started way back in the fall, and they both completed it.
Wonderful, congratulations.
So I wanted to bring them in. Come on up here.
Yeah, come on up. Let's read your names in the public record and we'll congratulate you.
This is Robert.
Robert, congratulations.
He is the water boy.
Congratulations.
And you are Rich. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
How wonderful.
See you.
Okay.
See you.
Congrats. And actually,
yeah, what's your list?
Robert here actually came to us. He had already done his EMT. Funding. One of the instructors is somebody that I work with already kind of channeled the power away. So he's already an EMT, he's already working for American Ambulance, so he's a certified firefighter.
So you're relatively new then to our.
Yes, both of these
good.
Guys are relatively.
Excellent. Well, thank you for joining us. We appreciate having you on board. And did you get their both
yes,
last
I
names?
Did.
All right.
Yeah,
excellent.
Completely new to us, so
excellent.
It's nice to have two more guys that. Certified or not certified, I mean,
yeah.
I can truck us the boys and we'll go off and do our thing. So they're both ready. Caroline's very familiar with Matt, so she can vouch for Matt.
Okay.
She was one of the reasons why he ended up with us. Is
oh well, good. That's great.
That's
right.
Through Caroline. So
excellent.
Yeah, both of these guys are certified, and I'm sure they'll pay in some of the dividends on what we've invested in them, so.
Perfect. Well, thank you for.
They both show up.
Thank you for bringing them.
Yeah, they're very active on calls and we've been able to utilize them already, so it's kind of a win-win. That helps tell them how to keep up with the water testing, so.
Yeah, all right, sounds good.
For your service.
Thank you.
All right.
All right, gentlemen.
We have another chief that just came in.
Question?
Yeah.
Good evening.
Hi.
Speak a while, I'll meet you.
One purchase order. Sheriff's Department sent their request for our annual dues for the SWAT team for $1,000. That will come out of our conference dues line item, it's an anticipated expense. It's purchase order number 1408 for the Stratford County Sheriff's Office.
Move purchase order number 1408, the Stratford County Sheriff's Office, for annual dues for the tactical team for $1,000.
Second.
Any discussion? Is it fair to say aye?
Aye.
Forgetting what the date is.
It's the ninth.
Yes, thank you.
The agenda for July 30th, did you anticipate a?
Is that the public hearing?
No.
No, 31st, yeah.
And what day of the week is it?
It's Monday.
No, the public hearing's Tuesday, though. We got too many comments.
July 31st?
The July 30th board meeting.
Yes.
The last Monday in July.
Yes.
Do you anticipate at this point a large agenda? What I'd like to do is I'd like to do the board tonight for some of the guys downstairs. I would love to have the board participate.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
It's hard to know, obviously things come up, but we would just pencil it in. Not pencil it in, we would just, yeah. So, July 30th. So.
I'll schedule for 7 p.m.
Yeah, 7 is usually what we like to do.
Sure, for the town to get things out of the way, what not, so.
Okay, that's great. Awards, all right. RPD. And then the following night is the bigger public hearing.
The public hearing.
And I don't know how many people might come, I don't know if it should be here or elsewhere.
We should get something out publicity wise.
Yeah, is there nothing out yet?
Just, you know, whatever you want to send to you, have to you, stay out there.
Yeah, okay. Did we see what time it was?
6:30. We had one vendor at 6:30 and one vendor at 7:30.
Oh, you're actually having presentations from the vendors?
Or actually.
Excellent. Who's, could you say who the vendor one is?
Yeah, vendor one is Best Way.
Best Way?
And vendor two is Groen.
And Groen is at 7:30?
Right.
And so then Best Way is at?
6:30.
6:30, I'm trying to put it by.
Did we decide where it was?
Well, there was some mention about having Legion, I don't know if we really need a room that big, but Legion, we don't have a large screen like that either for the folks to show. So I'd say we, let's plan on having it here.
Okay.
And if we have, we can take all the tables out, just put chairs. We have a table down front for maybe the committee and for the person doing the presentation.
Yeah, okay.
So. Yeah, if need be, I mean, we've got the chairs up there, we've got chairs upstairs, we can, downstairs, we can bring upstairs if needed, so.
All right, that sounds good.
That's all that I have for the board, anything for me?
I don't think so. Oh, yes, so what came up tonight was, George brought up a couple of items, we said, we asked him to take it to the Highway Safety Committee. So one was changing the position of the stop sign around the railroad tracks on Church.
Okay.
I can't say that I really understand, you know, it's a safety issue, he's thinking. The other one is, he's thinking he'd like to put a sign for the transfer station somewhere around there as well, so that people wouldn't go all the way in and could see it ahead of time. So we didn't know exactly where, I didn't know exactly where he meant, and I said, well, why don't you bring it up with the Highway Safety Committee at the same time?
Was that like an open and closed sign?
Sure, yeah.
For the transfer station?
Yeah.
And the other one is to prevent people from being stuck on the railroad tracks waiting for the traffic to come off of Church Street. I guess it happened to Ed.
Yeah.
Got stuck on, it was like, okay.
Yeah, it's not a comfortable spot, I mean, I've never, yeah, it's not a comfortable spot to be out there.
Has that ever come before?
No.
No.
We'll just blame Ed.
I know, in the past, there's some confusion, who has the right of way when you're coming up Church to make a left-hand turn on Jesse Dover.
Right.
Obviously, the folks coming down church have the right of way, but because you have the stop bar there for the railroad crossing, people get confused and think they should stop.
Yeah, there's a lot of, yeah, so. So I think he wants to review that.
Yeah, I know one time we talked about putting a sign on Church Street going towards the intersection of Jesse Toll and Church that said, you know, traffic turning left must yield to oncoming traffic, so. It never happened, so. But maybe with this it might, so.
Purchase order.
Oh, you get the bad eyes, are you? You're the only one.
I think it's just easier that way.
Yep.
And just submit with a bill.
I'm gonna send, I'm gonna get my permit for fireworks tonight, and I'll kind of send Harry down.
Sure.
Thank you.
So it's signed by both fire and?
Yes.
Yes, fire this year.
Is there any cost, or is it just pro forma?
They're free.
They're free.
Did we issue any for the 4th of July?
We did, we had four altogether for the week of July 4th.
Do we have any folks that,
We had a few, folks that did them off without permission, but.
I wasn't here, so.
I think two, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fucking on my usual day.
Lucky it was just two.
All right, well, good night.
All right, thank you.
You too. All right, let's see, transfer station. So this is, we're waiting for you, Mike, to give us a proposal for the ordinance.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yes.
So we'll just table it until we get it.
Please.
Okay.
Scheduled for?
It's scheduled for, oh goodness, August, I think.
Yeah.
And so we need to have it, August 6th, thank you, Tommy. Oops, we need to have it out to the people a full 7 days before, so. Dumpsters for buildings of 5 or more units. Is the board comfortable with just having Tom send out what he was?
The letter that he drafted to me was fine.
Oh, you've already seen a copy?
He sent it to us, yeah.
Okay, so we can just have him send it out?
Last week, we were just waiting on the, it was running the new list of,
Okay.
It was too far. It was approving the letter and then waiting for the list to be rerun. And we didn't approve the letter last week, so it's fine by me.
All right, so you're, I haven't read it, but the board, as a board, reviewed it, so okay, we'll just say, okay, please send. All right, so building permits, we're putting the, it's public information, so we're putting it on the website. It could be there as we speak, I'm not sure.
Right. So there was also a question of whether or not the actual application itself should be on the website. Did I see an email about that too, then? All right, so maybe I misunderstood, just the log, I don't know.
We're contemplating just log, because the log is already on Google Drive, and so the website just has a link to it. So, you know, if you go to it today, you'll see one thing. If you go to it 3 days from now, you might see something else, because as the log is updated, your link will just link to the log.
I guess I just misunderstood it was that Dover doesn't actually list, doesn't put online, you know, what has been issued, but it doesn't mean we shouldn't, but, or COs. I just misunderstood the email. I looked at it quickly. I'm fine with it.
Okay, all right.
Public records, so why not?
So the next one, just town property for personal use. I just wondered whether it might not be advisable to draft a letter to town officials, staff, employees, whatnot, saying, you know, town property is not for personal use. And there was an incident a few weeks back.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Say that again.
That just a friendly, you know, not coming down like a ton of bricks, but just, you know, a reminder that town property belongs to the town and is not to be used for, not to be removed, not to be used for personal use.
Right. We had a scheduled meeting and there was no
tables
to be had.
Right.
Yes. So.
Right, I saw that.
So. Okay. So I can, I'll ask Caroline to, when she has a minute, it probably won't be until after she's back up from vacation. Anything about recreation? Anything happening? This is just sort of a standing item at this time of year.
Yeah, we're meeting, like a postpone, we're meeting the third week of this month, just to go over things. I haven't really heard anything negative. Is there everything, do you know if everything's going well?
The issue I had heard about got resolved within a couple of days.
Okay, all right. And congrats on getting one of your grants.
Yep.
Oh, yes, we haven't seen you since then. Yes, nicely done, Celia. You spent a lot of time on that, so $1,000 is $1,000.
Yeah, and right now I'm working on programming for that.
Okay, good.
Getting that going, so. We've actually had, good news is that since the start of camp, 3 more people have expressed interest in the teen camp, which is still open for registration, and 2 of them have signed up, and another person expressed interest in Camp Raleigh. But the registration had already closed because of our numbers being so high.
So high, yeah, yeah. The teen camp had lower than anticipated numbers, so.
So we have had interest throughout the summer, which is good news.
That is good news. Yeah, that's good. We'll work on better budgeting
techniques. Yeah, maybe a revolving fund.
Yep.
And you know, and like, you know, I'm trying not to beat a dead horse, but on the other hand, I'm using it in the occasion to say, you know, if we met twice a month, then time can be spent for working on projects like looking for better ways to manage, like something like a recreation committee where there are fees coming in and expenses going out. And a revolving fund could be, like we were learned at the budget training session, could be a perfect way to manage that. It also could be, you know, George has talked about stocking culverts to sort of recycle, not to recycle, but to make available to folks with driveway culverts. That could be a little revolving fund possibly too. It's, you know, just fee-based. And so, you know, it's those kinds of projects that if we're just sort of, the more operational kinds of things we take on, the less time we have for these strategic things to make ourselves, you know, more efficient, more effective, that sort of thing. So, end of soapbox conversation.
Anything else to add about Greg? Okay. So it's no news is good news.
Yeah, it's just nice, you know, I saw Brittany, she was in today, you know, and it's just nice, his t-shirt, big stack letters on the back. And so, you know, if parents are coming by or anybody walking by, they can see,
right,
you know, that there are people in charge and there they are. Mm-hmm. So it's a really nice confirmation, reinforcement. It's good to see. Paul's integrity, I don't know what the current status is.
It hasn't been resolved.
Do you want to keep it on the agenda then,
please,
Mike?
Please, I need to talk to Tom again.
Okay.
Still some vehicles that are, champagne-colored SUV with no license plates on it in the middle of the, by his entrance, front entrance in the side by the Patterson's house. 2 of the vehicles have been removed, but that one hasn't been removed at all, and it certainly isn't registered, doesn't have license plates on it.
Okay.
And it has a main inspection sticker on it, too. So we just need to roll it back across the same place.
Okay.
We have an email. I don't know where it should come up, but one that just came from Paul Cass. He passed it on for some reason. A resident had a question. He thought it might come to the Conservation Commission. Doesn't go quite far about it, but folks had bought a house up on Wentworth Street. Want to put up a fence. They have some confusion about. I'll just read it to you if you want.
Sure.
We should be addressing it. Why not wait a week? My wife and I purchased a house on Wentworth Street in Rollins, sort of in the backyard. There's a tail end of what appears to be "quote unquote" conservation land, as the trees are marked, but it is our property. We have a dog, and we'd like a fence in the backyard for safety and peace of mind. Is it possible to put a fence through the woods in the back of the perimeter of our land? We would leave the trees and just put the fence on our property line. Just let me know what options we have and don't hesitate to reach out and all those contact info. We should have Tom Clark just reach out to the person. Forward it to Tom and have him address it.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
If it's, they can't cut down the trees. Right. That was the deal.
So we could ask Tom to use the opportunity to reinforce
them about that.
That no trees are to be
cut down. And the gentleman mentioned that he couldn't think.
And there's certainly not even a building permit.
No, you don't need a building permit.
Do you know why? Is there something rational about?
It's in the zone.
Yeah, I understand it's part of zoning, but
it's a driveway, and you have to do driveways.
Yeah,
it's not a building,
right? And so what? But no, I think fences are expressly, like, excluded. Mm-hmm. And so I'm just curious why would, because they're sensitive. you know, the setbacks, you need to make sure that they're, you know, following setbacks. It's just a curiosity.
There are rules about putting up the fence.
Yeah, they just don't.
You just don't have to, not have a building permit.
Yes, but those rules, you know, one way to make sure.
How do you follow them? How do you even know what the rules are?
Yeah, so it's remains a curiosity to me.
I mean, maybe there's just standard practice. You have to have X amount of feet to maintain the fence on your land. And the nice part of the fence has to face your neighbor, right?
Correct.
Well, that's convention. I don't know if that, you know, that's anywhere, but. Okay, so you're gonna forward.
That's my point. What's convention and what's the actual regulation? Doesn't seem to be.
Well, there's not, I don't think there's any, I don't think there's anything about fencing other than they're excluded from building permit process. So you're forwarding.
I'm doing it right now.
Okay. SRPC visioning, and we're gonna table that. Maybe I will put her on an on hold section until we're ready to, or the board is ready to kind of deal with it again. At this point, we probably are pushing back any thought of doing the village because, you know, next year will definitely be heritage and what's wrong. And we may need to bleed into the following year to finish it up. It kind of will depend on what the cost is. And then we've also got this, not a promise, but you know, what we've mentioned to Dover Public Works is that the earliest we could consider doing anything for Oak Street is 2020. So I don't know whether they're hoping to do something then or what. But so anyway, I don't know when we'll get back to the village, but. I think it's still a good idea to have an overall plan for what we think we're going to do there. Oak Street, did you perambulate?
On Sunday, I did.
And what did you discover?
Road's still there.
Okay. Did you find markers?
There's boundaries. Yeah, I didn't go all the way down. I wasn't sure if I was supposed to. I can again next weekend or this coming weekend. I didn't go down. I went from, I can't even name the damn street, Highland, Oak, you know, the Highland, Broadway intersection, all the way up to
Fresh Creek,
where it begins across from the old armory.
Yeah.
But I did go down Fresh Creek all the way down to Bear Road. I didn't walk down that.
Oh, that's in the middle of.
Well, yeah, but it's dry right now, so I mean, I guess I could, but I did not do that. But that would also be our part of the boundary. I had to look for the.
I can't remember. The markers are still there. So it actually goes into the. Do you have, you don't have it with you?
I don't have it.
Yeah. Well, I mean,
I was certain that I had to go that way. I mean, I didn't want to cross the Oak Street fence. I did drive, but I wasn't going to cross the railroad, so it wasn't happening. So.
Well, I mean, if you're comfortable with the perambulation and if the board is comfortable with your perambulating, you can just let.
Am I supposed to perambulate the entire time?
No, just the Oak
Street. Just that one section. Yes. Okay, good. Yeah. That's fine.
You could let Kevin Baum know that the board has done so and didn't find anything amiss. All right. One other thing that didn't make it to the agenda is that, so I don't know whether this came just to me, but when I let the Conservation Commission know about Bruce York's appointment, did you, so Linda Sue Solstorm sent in a resignation. So,
unrelated to Kevin Baum, it wasn't.
It's just, I mean, she just said, oh, it just, York. It's kind of like, oh, thank God, you know.
Someone else wants to be on.
There's, you know, I don't feel so bad because now there's a replacement. But so she felt in the final analysis it wasn't the best fit for her and she could do better by volunteering in other kinds of conservation projects. So I will just record that on the, I keep a list now for every committee about any action that takes place during the year. So I'll just add that she resigned and the. You're an alternate, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
So you'll have to, the commission will have to get another secretary.
Yes, I'm more than aware that Linda was our secretary.
Yes, I know. That's a tough one to lose.
Yeah.
Tough one to lose. All right, so that's just an announcement. All right, a transition plan. So Caroline sent the board an email with a, you know, pretty thoughtful document about what she thought the board might need going forward without me. And it, you know, we don't have to make decisions on those. We can have a preliminary conversation, but in any event, there would be money associated with those. And so, as I said earlier, what I hope to do when I get the budget is to see what I can scrape from various places so that the board has an idea of what it might have to work with to do some of that. The other thing that I started, you know, which is just something that I have been talking about that I would still be interested in doing whether I was, whether I resigned or not, is the, you know, how to make our meetings more efficient and effective and hopefully to get to 2 meetings a month. And so I did...
Can I ask a question about
yes.
the 2 meetings a month?
Yes,
why haven't we just done it? I mean, really didn't come up for a vote since I've been on. We talk about it, but we didn't vote on it.
No, we didn't. If you're ready to vote on it, I mean, Michael is very reluptant. I am, of course, gung-ho.
Well, you're going to be gone.
Would you stay
yes,
if we did? Until the end of the year?
Oh, no, that's a different question, Denise Mills.
I'm just asking.
She's trying.
Because I've been thinking about that. Or maybe a little longer than July 31st.
I will give that some serious consideration.
All right, well, let's postpone this conversation until next week.
Can I at least... If you haven't read my document, can I at least, like, kind of review
it? I couldn't actually open it. I tried
really?
A couple of times.
Oh, I read it. But yeah.
I wasn't on anything but my phone today. And I usually don't have an issue with my phone, so
yeah.
I don't know if it's just the Wi-Fi in the building I was in, maybe.
Well, some of the things that, you know, my assumptions in doing this is the board is most valuable when we're making high-level reviews and strategic decisions. You know, and that... The time we spent on small operate, and I don't mean small, I don't mean to downplay them, but they're operational, and they should be part of a business continuity plan that we've kind of provided for. So we're here for exceptions, for thinking about ways to make us more efficient and effective overall, whether it's energy savings or managing a new police station or all of those things that require, thoughtful kinds of things. And so that's one of the assumptions. And when we spend time on operational issues, we cut down on our ability to do that. And so when I say 2 meetings a month, it doesn't mean that we're not spending some time outside of that. Mm-hmm. So, you know, just like I spend time outside of our every Monday meeting mm-hmm. doing stuff, this would allow, you know, board members to think about and plan for and do proposals on various issues that the board thinks is important. So the places where I see opportunities right now is purchasing. And, you know, I've had this purchasing policy plan in the wings, and I haven't had time to go through it. But with it, if we adopt it, it has this limited purchase order. And where, is this new to you? So I can just, okay. So I don't remember what the ceiling is or threshold for this limited purchase order, but it's a purchase that we would review that. Whatever it is, if it's 500, if it's 1,000, it would allow a department head and Caroline to sign off on it. Mm-hmm. So two people, our primary administrative support and the department head. And Caroline would be there to make sure it's in the budget, blah, blah, blah. And so we wouldn't need to see those. We would see the ones that are for more than whatever the threshold is. And the other thing is, even when they come to us, like, we're sort of reading it into the record twice. The department head is reading it, we're reading it. So if the department head is reading it, we can just say, so moved, and then have a second. If somebody says, so moved, have a second, and then we talk about it. Mm-hmm. And that, you know, a minute here, 30 seconds there, and pretty soon it adds up to, you know, more significant time.
And we can also have, if we needed to bring them over to you, so you can get more...
Right.
Just afterwards, you know, so she can write down if she didn't catch it or something, you know, so then she can
see it
and do your thing,
absolutely.
And then we'll put it in the file.
Yeah. So you don't see any problem on your end if we were to do something like that?
No, as long as I have the information, it doesn't matter how it gets here. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Building permits, so we've already talked about that. You know, short term, you know, I think if we just sit here, you know, quietly sign them, look at them, sign them, and... you know, Sally can use that, I sort of have a stock thing that I suggested, but it can say anything. The board reviewed building permits and or certificates of occupancy. The building permit log is available to the public online or at town hall. And if there are weeks we don't, we just wouldn't put that in there. Because mm-hmm. sometimes we don't have building permits. Mm-hmm. And in the long term, of course, review the zoning ordinance and where applicable, change the select board to building inspector or as you were suggesting, you know, then that's perfectly fine too. That, you know, gives us the most flexibility.
Right.
And so in those periods when there might be a new building inspector and we wanted to do more thorough review with him or her, it would give us the opportunity mm-hmm. to do that. Mm-hmm. Welfare administration. So that's the other thing that I brainstormed with Caroline, is that most towns don't get involved in the same level of detail. Now, there was a time when we were actually the person, which was really difficult because of the lack of consistency in our part. We are so much better off, and I hope the board agrees, mm-hmm. with having one person in charge of this. Mm-hmm. But what we might consider doing is having her come to us and see how other towns, because she's plugged in with how other towns manages, and if there are certain authorizations that we can officially give her,
right.
you know, to either a certain level or a certain, I don't know what, but mm-hmm. something that we're comfortable with. And, you know, we need to be able to trust our staff employee that if there's an issue or something funny or different, she would come to us and say, look, I don't know what to do with this one.
Yeah.
There must be a way to make that work. For a lot of communities do not, the select board actually doesn't issue, even though we are the arbiters of last resort or arbiter, overseers of the poor, we're part of our official title. They don't actually do the administrating of the welfare, even in small towns.
Same with building permits.
Building permits. Part of zoning ordinance. I mean, that's sort of.
Well, no, I understand. We have to change.
The statutes allow us to do what you're suggesting, so.
Yes, so we just need to.
We have to work with the parameters. That's fine by me. And I think it's. We've saved money ultimately because we have a consistent process. I mean, before it was, you know, whoever. You could pigeonhole sitting here by themselves and to give them what you wanted.
No, it was frickin' frack administrative welfare. No offense to any of us, but I was one of the fricks and fracks.
It was
doing
horrible.
Yeah.
Right, and at least she has all the, she has the checklist, she has everything.
No,
she
there are also laws that we're supposed to follow
exactly.
that we're not aware of.
Right, and she
right.
has her contacts,
right.
she's developed contacts mm-hmm. with other towns and municipalities. So here's something that, you know, in my calculations, I think we have to consider. So if the board chooses to pilot meeting twice a month, and should that end up being feasible, so that we can pilot for the rest of this year, then the board can discuss reducing the select board stipend mm-hmm. for FY 2019,
right.
you know, because we do have a generous stipend, and it's based largely on the kinds of operational issues that we get involved in.
Right.
And so we can take a look at that, and it while it isn't, we're not going to reduce it to zero, but I mean, we could think, and it won't be a lot of money, but you know, whatever. Again, you know, $1,000 here, $1,000 there can help
yeah.
defray some of the costs for reworking
yeah.
our operational budgets.
100%
and
that.
The other thing is just, again, you know, it should go up under assumptions or something. That is, you know, the other thing that is good to do is foster ways to. Enhance business continuity so that people aren't waiting for a board that meets once a week
mm-hmm.
or
right.
once every, even if it's just once a week, even if we do meet once a week, you still have to wait
mm-hmm.
for things that, you know, really for, in this day and age, you know, it'd be nice if the town had considered other ways so that people who need us to provide business answers can have a way to do that.
Mm-hmm.
So that's sort of it. I don't know if there's any kind of larger conversation that you want to have about that. I will consider what you said. Darn.
So, yeah, I didn't have access to what
right, so,
you had spent today, but I did have some other questions about projects that you're working on, if we could get a list of those.
Yes.
What duties you're performing outside of the Monday meetings.
Yes.
Would be helpful. I mean, there's not going to be a vacuum. I mean, there will be someone put in your place if you do resign. So, that person and the two people sitting here will absorb those duties. So, the things will get done. But we need to know exactly what they are.
Caroline is going to sit with me.
Okay.
And to capture that, start to
okay.
capture that. So. I don't know when you would see it. She's on vacation next week, so we may, what's really important is that I get the budget from her this week.
Right.
So if there's time for me to sit with her this week, I can start that. But,
okay.
Yeah.
And being that I'm the alternate for the budget, I'd like to go with you if you do go to that meeting, so then I can.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I'd love to have. I'd love to have board members there anyway. It's
yeah.
it's a good thing.
So, if that
absolutely.
Ends up being a transition, and I'm on it, then
yes.
I make sure that they understand what's going on.
Perfect. Absolutely, I would welcome that. Did you have a question or?
Well, comment? I just wanted to find out what was what things were being planned. It seems like things are kind of rolling along. If there was a meeting with Caroline to find out what duties you're doing, and because my view is, I happen to realize that you've been doing an awful lot, Suzanne, and I know that. And I don't know that somebody who comes in is going to necessarily do all those things. It would be a lot more coming on all the other members of the board. And it may well be that if you can pick up some of that through your administrative staff, it would be helpful. It just seems to me, because I like the idea. One of the things that I've been thinking about, and after my conversations with both you, and I've already talked to Caroline. I haven't finished that part of my report, but it seems to me, as you mentioned, continuity. I like the idea of having continuity on an administrative basis, so that if a bus hits the three of you, the town doesn't stop tomorrow. I don't want a bus to hit anybody. I'm
sure.
really kind of worried
sure.
about that.
Well,
and
this,
it just seems to me.
So
that
I hope this is reflected
little,
in the report that your committee
yes,
is working
well,
on.
Well, that absolutely. That's
yeah.
one of the things that seems to be coming up, and I'm thinking this continuity issue. Sort of like institutional knowledge and things like that you might want to be able to pass on, because
right.
if
we have so few standard operating procedures and the things that are written down, we have so few of that sort of thing.
I know.
It's it's in one person's head, and we have limited redundancy on an administrative
I realize that these are some of the things that are just
right.
I
mean,
as
have, I
look at this, I'm kind of going
we've got the police have policies and processes, the fire does, but from otherwise, our own administrative support, there's very little redundancy. It, we've made some strides. I can't say we haven't made strides. Google Drive has been amazing. And, but there, when you start out and you've got this much to fill, and there's nothing in it yet, it takes a while before you can build capacity. So, but anything that you can reflect in, when might we expect?
As well, we have. I'm going as fast as I can. I know that Dee and Kathy was going to be interviewing the chief, and then she was going to talk to five of her towns. I know Dee was going to talk to five towns, and she was going to be talking to George and to Andrea. And I still have to talk with Kate and the fire chief.
Yeah.
So I'm going to hope I can grab him this week.
How many towns do you mind?
15.
That's what
15.
We picked 15 because we found what we were looking for was towns of similar population and similar tax base,
mm-hmm.
and we found about 15 that were pretty close to us.
Okay.
And that's those were our cohort.
Yep. Did that spreadsheet that I had, was that helpful in determining the 15?
Yes, it was. As were other things that Kathy had pulled,
okay.
and it was quite good.
Right.
So.
All right, excellent. Okay, anything else to talk about?
So, I'm glad Lorraine is here, because that was my question. When do we think we can anticipate this report? Because a lot of what you're suggesting, in my mind, depends on a different level of administrative support than what this town operates under currently. So. That's my reluctance in moving to twice a month, is that I'm not confident that the administrative support that other towns that are able to accomplish this have in place that we don't have in place. We don't have a town administrator, we don't have a town manager, whichever one you want to go with. We don't have that. We have a part-time bookkeeper / administrative assistant that's full-time in her administrative duties, part-time in her bookkeeper. So, but there are more and more things we keep asking of one person, and it's not sustainable in my mind. So under the current way we're operating, so that's where my reluctance comes in.
Well, your reluctance to move to...
To 2 times a month, so...
But I think some of the things that we're talking about are not, I mean, other than the limited purchase order, which would require, you know, Carolina Department Head, you know, the welfare decisions that she is making, you know, it would, you know, it would save her from coming here. Although one of the things that I know that she is suggesting and that I would encourage us to seriously consider, the board seriously consider, is to have her sit at this meeting. And again, if it were twice a month, yeah, it would be less of a commitment. But, because right now that's a function that was missing when I was first on the board, as you know, there was little follow through for any, you know, we were reactive with little follow through, and sometimes it took somebody coming 2 or 3 times before something got resolved. So, so that would be, so again, you know, that's why, you know, I'm going to be looking for pots to scrape, you know, so that you can, or we can work together, depending on when this happens, to consider how best to position us, to provide some redundancy that we don't have, to fill in for the continuity aspects of what I currently do as far as communication. The Monday, Tuesday sort of thing where, you know, I'll take a look at what we did and make sure that everybody has their marching orders, that sort of thing. And I know individual pieces are taken up by either of you, but you know, most of it is on this sheet or was on my laptop. Mm-hmm. And so that would probably best be managed by inviting Caroline to sit in on this meeting. All right, anything else about the transition? All right, board member activities and updates. I don't think I have any.
Planning board tomorrow night.
Oh, okay, excellent. Yeah. Very good.
I have something. I can't remember what it is.
You were going, yes, because it was going to hit the stormwater, and I rescheduled the stormwater.
What day was it, Wednesday?
Wednesday.
Oh, CIP.
That's it.
The CIP, my remake of CIP. So I will be meeting with CIP.
Yes, your rehearsal will now be
yes, it will. So we're doing that, and then I have recreation the following week, and that's it.
So the reason I rescheduled the stormwater committee, we were originally scheduled to meet on Wednesday, is that I touched base with the Seacoast Stormwater Coalition, and we are meeting at the end of July, and they're going to provide us, we're going to be working on pages 1 and 2 of the permit, which is like, you know, 20 pages long. And what, with a homework assignment to make sure that they're giving us maps with our impaired waterways. So obviously the same Falls River will be one. I think probably Fresh Creek and others may be there. And so what they're going to require us to do is make sure that our outfalls are mapped on this. So that's what the, you know, we've got things, so I don't think that will be an issue. But we need to, what they said was, we'll give you the maps, you know, take them home, do your homework, put the outfalls on them, and then come back because the rest of the activities that you're going to fill in are going to depend on the number and placement of your outfalls. So I said, oh, okay, fine. So I rescheduled the Stormwater Coalition's, our Stormwater Committee, so that it would be after the July Seacoast Stormwater and before the August one. So again, assuming that I'm not on the board, which is my intent at right this very moment, I would ask the board to consider appointing me to the Stormwater Committee so that I can continue the that I have started with that. Not that it's a favorite thing to do, but we have to get it done. Mm-hmm. End of story. We've got to have something in by October 1st. And it's going to require some oversight. Mm-hmm. I mean, because this is going to be, we're going to be saying, this is what we're doing first year, second year, and the most fleshed out piece is the first year. And it shouldn't be too difficult. I don't remember exactly what, but any of the education pieces, they're going to be available via this group. So we just pick, you know, this brochure, that video, put a link to it. Do you know what I mean? So the best thing we ever did was to fall into the Seacoast Stormwater Coalition and to pay our $1,000 a year as far as help with stormwater management. Because the other piece that is really helpful is that it's giving this region a consistent approach to it. So if EPA comes knocking or whatever, we're all saying the same thing. You know, we're all looking at outfalls and defining outfalls in the same way. You know, it's the most proximate source that's dumping into the river, not, you know, three segments back. You know, so those kinds of things are invaluable in having feeling better about the kind of information that we're going to be packaging to DES and EPA. So that's a long way to say what the Stormwater Committee is doing, but I don't have anything actively scheduled for this week. All right, so building permits. Yep. So we can just use our new approach if you want, and just kind of, you can look them over and pass them on to me, and I can pass them on to Denise. And then you can, are you ready to start, will be ready to start doing the correspondence?
Right here.
Yeah, you know, and I don't know if there are ways that you can see to make that piece
easier,
better, or I don't really know. That was a puzzlement. I know the board, school board, sort of has somebody scan things, right? Was that it for building permits? Okay, so these are abatement recommendations that we're getting from, is this the first batch we've received?
Second batch.
Okay. All right, so we have to talk about those, right? Are they public?
We just have a discussion in a non-public session, and then they become the decision of public.
Okay, so maybe we should do the correspondence first, Mike?
Yeah, works for me.
Okay, I have a purchase order 1452 for Pike's Industry for $287,742.68, regrading and reclaiming a paving for Heritage and Woods Run.
So moved.
Second. Okay.
So this is really, we had the contract, but we never did a purchase order, and it's unclear to me, do we need both? I guess we do, I don't know.
Yeah, I think it's
okay. So this is just the purchase order that reflects what we've already done, so. Any questions or comments? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So the next time when we do the contract, we should have a purchase order as part of it then.
Mm-hmm.
That's really the way we should
Exactly. Purchase order 1453 for Jody Lavoie Carnes. Various supplies for summer recreation, $159.70, and there are receipts attached.
Second.
All right, I should have said something when I saw this sort of flip by. I think maybe the more appropriate thing is a request for disbursement, you know, that form, because it's not a purchase order, it's a reimbursement, right?
And so next time we have it, do it next time.
You know, it's small, it's under 200, and so bring in the receipts, attach them to the request for disbursement, so, but this also works. We just need a mechanism so that we're saying, okay, so let's do that. All those in favor say aye.
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 Aye. I mean, it's a relatively new form. I think we instituted it based on Tom about a year and a half ago. And it's worked well for these kinds of either our stipends or...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely.
So things like this.
Okay. So the next one is... Federal Quarterly Form 941X for the town of Rollinsford needs to be signed three times. I think it's three of the same copies. It's payroll tax return.
Oh, this is the correct, corrected.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so.
So I think it has to be signed by you because it's only one signature spot.
So let me just reiterate what is going on here. So this is in tax year 2017, we neglected to take out Social Security for our non-police retirement folks. So that was road agent and our administrative assistant. So so what we need to do on their behalf is make sure that they have a corrected Social Security or W-2,
right.
So they've got the benefits ascribed to them. The money to support it is coming out of the general fund.
Okay.
But this is not, this, I think there's no money with this. This is just the correction?
This is the correction, right, when I, you know, this is July, August, and September's correction. So, but there's three copies, you have to make sure you sign all three of them.
Keep this page for your records, do not mail. Please sign all and enter required information as soon as you're allowed. Sign here. Okay. Today is September, July 2018. Start reading something else. We're gonna try to attend at the same time.
The next one, I'm not really sure I understand this. I can, maybe Mike does. It's from Citizens Bank, and it says, Brian and Suzanne, unfortunately, we were unable to accept the forms you recently signed as Suzanne needs to sign herself, not Michael.
Mm-hmm.
Did you sign it?
Yes.
For Citizens mm-hmm. Bank. Did you sign your name or
her? I signed them on her behalf, and I
initialed
them.
Oh, okay.
As the vice chair, because okay. We had to wait.
Okay, but so it said, please sign two copies and return two to me.
I don't know why they wouldn't accept it.
Well, it says you have to sign it yourself. Mm-hmm. So, and Vern has to resign them as well.
Okay.
So those need your signature. Citizen Bank, Government Banking. This is from Vern. It says, this is the signature form for the... I can't resign. I can't read that word. Triple? Is that triple?
Hi. This is the signature form for the high interest yielding investment.
Okay, high interest. I couldn't read this writing.
No, I know.
One of the selectmen needs to sign. We're indicated on page 3 and return to Vern afterwards. So does it say chair? It does not. Do you want to sign it, Michael? No?
Yeah. That's fine with me. Well, I don't care. All right, I think I have, if you want to look, I don't know. There's more than three things here.
There's three, oh, I thought there was three.
So I'll just make a comment. I've been really pleased with the treasurer's report. It has more detail.
Yeah.
And it is, I like the format. It's very professional, and what I believe our treasurer is doing is looking for ways to, again, you know, scrape, you know, money here and there mm-hmm. in short-term ways, so that's really helpful to
that's
us.
That's good for the town.
Yep.
Okay. The next one is Dumais and Fernald Certified Public Accountants, forms W-2C and W-3C, no payment due, sign and date on the X. Mail an envelope and mail employee copies now.
So I believe these are signed. Okay. And this is Citizens Bank.
Sign an end date right now. Well, this must be pertaining to the same incidents with the...
Oh, the
Social Security, Social Security issue. Because there's... Yes, there's individuals that were affected by that.
Okay, so this is the sign.
Okay. I'm sorry. Just... Mm-hmm.
I These are signed.
Okay. All right.
I'm sorry.
One more. Okay, thank you.
All right, so this is.
A W-2.
Does this convey to them then?
That must be what they're gonna get for their tax, there's the attachments behind there shows the individuals. You missed one.
I did.
There's a sign here, there's no signature.
All right.
Let me just make sure. There's a sign there. There's a sign there. Okay, there's this down there. There's this one. So that one's all set. This one. This one. And then I have a signature for appointing official listed below firm. The above named individual shall be appointed to the town of Rollinsville representative of the Stratford Regional Planning Commission.
Yes, so they sent us an email. Oh, no, we voted on Michael. You were to be our, to replace Judy. We did notify them, but they wanted us to do this, I guess. So the signatures of the appointing officials listed below confirm that the above named individual, it's actually not above. So you are the appointee. Michael, do you want a middle initial? I'll let you fill those things in.
Good size.
Thank you for reviewing that. Tax season must be over, huh?
Yeah. They have time for these multiple forms.
Yes. He also gave us our financial statements, which are in file. So the 2017 financial statement is has been received.
Okay, so this was Department of Revenue Administration, Municipal Property Division. I have a note here that follow up with Mike and Suzanne.
Oh, is this the equalization thing? Or what is this?
Current use.
Current.
Working with Caroline on it.
Oh, you're working with Caroline, okay.
So are we all set on that then? Because I see a bunch of initials, CK. Is that Caroline?
Yes.
Well, CKR. What's the R stand for?
Maybe it's a typo?
I don't know.
Or maybe it's not hers.
Maybe it's not her?
Okay.
Yeah, most often.
So what am I going to do with this?
You still working on it? You want to keep it in that folder?
Leave it in it. So we'll put it as a follow up in here?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Could
the questions, they were suggesting, bless you, that we have deficiencies in our.
Yes, yeah, and you were
doing it.
Right. So what did you, have you found any?
We haven't had time. We've talked about it. We have not figured it out.
Okay. So Mike, I don't know whether you can appoint yourself. I don't see anything wrong. Or Denise can sign it. Okay, so this is appointing Mike to the Stratford Regional.
My pleasure.
Yes, we've already officially did it, but Stratford Regional wants that appointment letter.
Got it. All right, all set.
Yep.
All right. And then.
Congratulations and thank you.
Yeah. Let me just make sure. I think I'm all set. I believe that's it for me. And do those go back to you, Mike?
All right. So we are going to go into non-public, so to review abatements. We'll come out of that and probably have some decisions, which I can relate to you, Salman. You can wait out there if you want, folks, or just read it in minutes. But in any event, I'll ask to see if there's community input from anybody. Celia?
Yeah, there was a resignation from the REC committee, and I wanted to make sure that made it to the board.
No.
Or,
okay. Not that it made it to me.
Okay. One person had resigned by email.
Who?
Liberty Roy.
Oh, I did get that. I'm sorry.
So would you like me to remove her from the distribution list?
Yes, I can forward the email that she sent to the committee.
Yeah, I did get it. I have it. I can forward it.
To the select board.
Yeah,
Denise can forward it.
That was quite a while ago.
Yeah, it was in the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, okay. Sorry, I do have that one.
So I just, because you were talking about resignations.
Yes, well, I like to keep them in the membership thing, so anybody's looking at it will know not only who we appointed first, but any activity that's happened in the interim. So that way, it's just easier for us to keep track, and the next year we'll have a better handle on things.
It wasn't anything wrong, just a personal decision.
Yeah, it's time-consuming, and we appreciate people who do serve. Yes, Charlie?
Yes, is the CIP noted on the board, posted for Wednesday?
I don't know, Charlie. You can tell me. You know it's not.
I didn't see it there.
Okay, just tell me. I'll get it done.
Okay.
And in your discussion about the fence viewer, every year we have...
I'm sorry, about the what?
Fence viewer. The fences. We, at town meeting, always elect a fence viewer. So is that the person that's responsible for the fences versus you guys?
No, I believe they're unrelated.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just thought maybe they didn't do building permits because the fence viewer is supposed to be that jurisdiction.
Well,
that's
fence viewer works on disputes.
Michael's a historian on those vestigial colonial positions.
Exactly. Yeah.
So I just didn't know
at least one of us would really like to discontinue.
And to be fair, they're on it.
Yeah, but they take up time and talent, so. All right. Anything else? All right. So I will encourage a motion or accept a motion.
We're going to non-public session to deal with abatement.
Okay. Okay. Roll call, Michael.
Yes.
Denise.
Yes.
Suzanne. Yes.